Stretch the muscles of the front of your neck and strengthen the ones of the back. That's all that we hear these days for fixing forward head posture. But is this the actual solution of the problem? The quick answer is no. According to Dr. Capanzi, for every inch that your head is moving forward, 10 pounds of weight are added to what your neck is forced to support. This means that at a distance of 2 inches away from your neutral position, your muscles are holding 20 pounds more than they should be. But take a second and think about that. If they can hold 20 pounds more than they should be holding in neutral position, how is strength training going to help these muscles? Taking the right position would mean less weight, and this of course will require less strength. And this is why we often see strong and well-developed athletes having poor posture. Unfortunately, most of the advice that we hear these days insists on the misleading idea that you need to strengthen the muscles of the back area of your neck in order to pull your head in the neutral position. In this video, I'm going to explain why this is not true, and I will present you the only way to fix forward head posture proven by science and basic principles of biomechanics. Let's get started. To get things straight, you first need to know if you do have forward head posture. Many times, the forward position of the head comes as a result of a hyperkyphotic thorax, or in other words, hunchback. In many cases, hyperkyphosis also comes along with rounded shoulders. Nevertheless, as was shown by Singla and Vicar in 2017, forward head posture, rounded shoulders, and hyperkyphosis can either exist alone or in any combination. If they do exist in combination, fixing hyperkyphosis first will automatically improve forward head posture. And this is what has been found in most of the studies that tried to improve both of these conditions simultaneously. Identifying the real issues of your posture is a serious and time-consuming process that I will not get into in this video. For this reason, I have created a completely free postural assessment guide so you can easily evaluate your posture and have a clear picture of the alignment of all your joints. You can find the link in the description below. So first thing, make sure that you do have forward head posture. If you identify hyperkyphosis, you should definitely fix it first. Otherwise, any exercises on your neck will not have any effect. To do that, you can simply watch my video on hyperkyphosis. Now, in order to fix forward head posture, we need to know what causes it and then address all these reasons effectively. So what is the cause of forward head posture? The most common misconception is that tight muscles on the front of your neck pull your head forward, while the muscles of the back are slowly getting weaker and thus can't keep your head in neutral position. But let me explain why this is not true. The force that drives your head to the front comes from three different factors. 1. A hyperkyphosis in the thoracic spine, which forces your head to turn in order to be able to see. Reason number 2. Gravity. As was pointed out by Fala and colleagues in 2007, the main function of the cervical spine is to orient the head against the force of gravity. To give an example, if the muscles that keep my back straight stop activating, I will fall towards the front. This is caused by gravity and not because the muscles of the front of my body are tight and pulling me. In the case of your neck, the two forces that are being balanced are gravity and the muscles that work against gravity, not the tight SCM muscle that is pulling you to the front. Seeing people propose that the tight SCM muscle is pulling your head to the front and that you should stretch these muscles in order to fix forward head posture means that they probably don't really know what is the function of the SCM muscle. The SCM muscle causes lateral flexion and rotation when contracting unilaterally, and elevation of the head when contracting bilaterally. So if a tight SCM muscle had the power to involuntarily pull you to a wrong position, this position would look something like this in a unilateral contraction, or like this in a bilateral contraction. Other muscles like the deep cervical flexors can move the head forward, but they constitute a small muscle group that works with the assistance of gravity in order to pull your head forward. You can easily realize that if you try the supine position head tuck. Now that the same muscle group is working against gravity and not with the assistance of gravity, you could hardly stay in this position for a few seconds. In contrast, you can stay in forward head posture all day long, and that's because gravity is doing the work for you. So specifically for the forward head posture, forget the concept that tight muscles are pulling you towards the front. At the same time, this doesn't mean that these muscles are not tight. Holding your head to the front for a long period will definitely affect many muscles of your neck that you definitely need to stretch and alleviate. The thing is that these muscles go tight because of your prolonged forward head posture and not the other way around. The third and most important reason that keeps your head in a forward position is habit. If you can hold your head in neutral position but you forget it for the rest of the day, that means that you have developed a bad habit. Think like this. If you put your weight on your one leg while standing, this doesn't mean that you must strengthen the glutes and stretch your adductors to correct your movement. It just means that you must remember to stand straight. Now, if you do stay straight but you're quickly tired, this is called lack of muscle endurance, and we're going to solve that by the end of this video. The second misconception is that you should strengthen the muscles of the neck and upper back in order to pull your head in the neutral position. But as I have already said in the beginning of this video, Dr. Kapanji has calculated that our muscles actually support way more weight when our head is on a forward head posture. At 2 inches away from the vertical axis, your muscles support 20 pounds more than they should be for the entire day. So bringing your head back means that they have to carry 20 pounds less. Does this sound like these muscles need more strength? I'd really like to see what you think of that in the comments. This was also evidenced in a study of Oliveira and Silva in 2015. While trying to establish the relationship between forward head posture and neck pain, they found out that patients with forward head posture had actually more endurance capacity for both neck flexors and neck extensor muscles than subjects with no forward head posture. In addition, 3 more studies failed to demonstrate significant differences in the muscle strength of patients with and without forward head posture. But think also in a simpler way. There are many strong and well-developed athletes who maintain poor posture. If you're not training regularly, strength training is essential. But to fix forward head posture, what your muscles need is strength endurance in a specific position, and this is a completely different concept as a training procedure. To be able to get them working in this position, you need first to exercise postural awareness. So now that we know what causes forward head posture, let's see how to fix it. The solution comes in 3 different phases, and I will place them in a hierarchical order according to how important they are in this process. First, you need to develop postural awareness. You need to know where the right position of the head is and where it isn't. This comes through postural awareness exercises that I will present in a minute. Once you're able to feel where the right position of the head is, you need to develop strength endurance in this position. This comes through specific strength endurance exercises. But the most important factor for fixing forward head posture and the base of all your efforts is changing your habits. I know that when it's so simple, it doesn't look compelling as a solution, but this is the number one reason for having forward head posture in the first place, so if you don't change that, you have absolutely no chance of making progress. I promise to give practical advice and some innovative solutions on how to do that. Now let's see every step in detail. For postural awareness exercises, I recommend doing similar exercises to the ones that were used by studies that dealt with forward head posture successfully. These exercises include movements that drive the head in and out of its neutral position, so you can slowly develop the ability to recognize what is wrong and what is right. First, from a standing position with the back straight against the wall, move in and out of the neutral position of the head. Every time you take the neutral position, hold it for 2 seconds. This exercise moves the head in and out of the correct position in the sagittal plane, which develops body awareness on this plane. Then, while on neutral position, change positions between chin tuck, neutral position and chin up. This exercise rotates the head higher and lower than the correct position, therefore developing awareness in the frontal axis. A good place to start for both exercises is 3 sets of 10 repetitions with 1 minute rest, but feel free to adjust the volume to what feels right to you. Remember that these exercises are meant to help you develop better understanding of the correct position of your head. Once you can easily feel and assume the correct position, your next goal is to develop strength endurance in this position. I divide these exercises in high intensity low volume and low intensity high volume. The high intensity exercise would be a head up hold from prone position. This is an isometric exercise. A good place to start here is 6 sets of 15 seconds with 30 seconds rest in between. Of course, you should always adjust the volume and intensity to what feels more suitable to you. The low intensity exercise is the same push of the head to its neutral position, but this time while sitting and with a roll towel as a resistance between the wall and the head. This is the low intensity exercise, so you only need to keep the towel from falling down and keep the position for at least 2 minutes in every set. A good place to start here is 6 sets of 2 minutes with 2 minutes rest in between. After a couple of times, adjust the volume and intensity to what feels best for you. These are the only exercises that you need for fixing forward head posture. It's a very careful exercise selection specifically for the purpose of fixing forward head posture and not a random program featuring every exercise for the upper back that exists. And the final and most important step of this process is change your habits. First, you need to adjust your environment according to your body and needs. Adjustments like this would be placing your screen higher, choosing a better chair, or taking a more comfortable position when you're on your phone. Take the time to identify which habits are responsible for your forward head posture and find alternatives that can slowly eliminate them. But even then, the main point is to remember to keep good posture, otherwise you will quickly fall back to your old habits. So the main thing that you need here is something to remind you to keep good posture throughout your day and especially the hours that you know that you keep poor posture, thus replacing bad habits with good ones. This is where the science of biofeedback comes in place. With biofeedback, you can get instant feedback and notifications on how you're standing in real time. The most scientifically proven device to do that is the upright. As was shown by these studies, the use of the upright device improved the posture of the patients simply by reminding them to do so every time they took the wrong position. This video is not sponsored by Upright, and the only reason that I support this device is because it is actually scientifically proven to work and not another useless widget that I see on the internet. Its function is simple, and this is to remind you to take good posture every time you don't. On the other hand, an inexpensive way to do that would be to simply schedule reminders on your phone throughout your day and correct your posture every time they ring. Make sure to schedule these reminders in the hours of the day that you'll know that you'll need them most. These are the only 3 steps that you need for fixing forward head posture. Note that if you're not training regularly, strength and flexibility will do wonders for your health and wellness, so make sure to get in a program as soon as possible. This is not something to fix forward head posture, but to build overall strength and health. Summary. So let's summarize everything we saw. The head falls toward the front because of hyperkyphosis, gravity and habit, and not because tight muscles are pulling it. Your neck extensors are probably already strong enough, so the solution for this particular problem will not come by increasing strength. Fixing forward head posture comes in 3 different phases. Phase 1, develop postural awareness with the 2 exercises that we saw. This simply means being able to feel where is the neutral position of your head and neck. Phase 2, develop strength endurance in the neutral position of the cervical spine with the other 2 exercises that we saw. Phase 3, create good habits to replace bad habits by scheduling reminders throughout your day or by using innovative equipment like the upright device. I promise to put a link in the description below where you can free download all the program in a PDF. I hope that you practice these steps, and I'm waiting to hear about your progress in the comment section below. If you found this video helpful, share it with your friend that needs to see it, hit the like button below, and don't forget to subscribe because I will be making more science explained videos in various topics. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.